My pleasure and my honor to introduce our musical scholars this evening. I want to thank our directors, Ms. Lawton, Ms. Evans, and Ms. Collins for the opportunity to introduce this fantastic show. We got a little preview of it this afternoon at Fairgrave, and it is amazing. You're going to be so proud of all of our scholars up here. They've made such progress throughout the year, and their talent is surely going to shine tonight. So thank you to everyone for being here tonight. We really appreciate you coming out and for making sure that our scholars are here to perform. If I could have everybody take out their phone right now and just make sure that you've got it on silent, you've got your volume all the way down, any other device you might have with you, make sure that the volume is all the way down and it's on silent mode. We would really, really appreciate it. Any of those extraneous sounds, noises, alerts, alarms, those kind of things can distract from an already, as you know, slightly nervous person on stage. So again, we appreciate you making sure that those are all on silent and the volume is all the way down. Without further ado, I'm going to turn it over to Ms. Evans. Thank you so much. And break a leg, everyone.
It's not going to work. Oh, I have the worst luck with microphones. Like, I'm so self-conscious for them, and then they don't work when I want them to. Very fun. Our first piece is called Volo Waltz, and it starts out kind of at the beginning, where we all are using pizzicato to make our tone. It's the first thing that we learn when we learn to play a stringed instrument. And I am having the second year players join the first year players just for moral support. And they can play the slasher. So some of the parents are going to recognize it, but it's fun. Here's Willow Waltz. To read on the musical staff. So this is where the real music literacy kind of kicks in. This is our favorite.
Once upon a time, there was an old gray goose who lived on a farm. The farm belonged to a lady whom everyone called Tom Brody. Gray goose is getting awfully old. I better cook him up for my holiday dinner this year before it gets too tough to eat. Aunt Rody's neighbor on the next farm was Pierre, the French chef. Hello, Aunt Rhody. What can I do for you on this beautiful day? Well, I'd like to borrow your biggest roasting pan. I'm gonna cook that old gray goose for my holiday dinner. Oh, mon Dieu, don't cook the old gray goose. Perhaps you will change your mind after you have eaten some of my hot broth bones. Very tasty, Pierre. But tomorrow I'm still gonna cook that old gray goose. How can you be so cruel? Well, I'm no more cruel than that girl Mary. Haven't you heard the gossip about her?
What is it?
Well, I heard that for dinner the other night, Mary had a little lamb. Was very upset, so that night he went to see the old gray goose. Did you know, mon ami, that Aunt Rhody was planning on having you for her holiday dinner?
Delightful. And what is she serving?
You. Quick, run down to the river and take my rowboat. Row away as fast as you can. The next morning, Pierre went to see Aunt Rhody and told her how he wanted the old gray goose. He warned the old gray goose and gave him the rowboat.
Oh, that's all right, Pierre. I was really very fond of that goose. I never could have cooked him. As a matter of fact, I miss him already.
Just then, the old gray goose came waddling over the hill.
Don't cry, Aunt Rhody. I knew you would never be mean enough to hook me.
Oh, dear, I'm so sorry you had to run away and row down the river in the cold, bad air.
Well, at least something good happened on the way down the river. I met a new friend. His name is Turkey Lurkey.
Would you care to meet him sometime, Aunt Rhody?
Oh, I certainly would. I certainly would.
The old gray goose, Aunt Rhody. Brody and Pierre all laughed and then joined hands and danced a lively polka. Good evening. We are the Fairbairn Gross. We have three pieces for you today. The first one is My Favorite Things from The Sound of Music. If you've ever seen the movie, this is the scene where she's trying to calm the kids by letting them think of all the good, happy things that they like. It doesn't work right away, but it takes a minute, and we really love this song. This is My Favorite Things.
Raindrops on roses and whiskers on kittens.
The sun will bow on your behalf so that you don't clunk each other's heads. But they're just really wanting to bow. You know, I just can't stop a person who's a show person. Our second piece today was a hot topic because it's called It's Still Fun, It's No Fun. One is we love the snow and all the things about it, and the other is we hate it. It's terrible and I want to go on vacation in Mexico. They're going to do each one, and then we're going to do one of them a second time to show you when we voted what was the most popular opinion, okay? So if we sing the one that's like, yeah, Bahama, most of them hated winter, okay? If you hear the happy one, then most of them love winter. So see if you can figure out which one you think we're going to do. Here we go.
We have a choice to build or destroy. Up next is our Fairgrade band.
Okay. Hi, I am Stephanie Collins, the director of the Fairgrade Band this year. Before we get started, I just want to give all of you a big, huge thank you for allowing me to teach these wonderful people. I enjoy them so incredibly much. They are. I can't even tell you, there are days that I come home from Fairgrade on Wednesdays, Thursdays, and Fridays, I am exhausted. They are so musical, I mean, I know that that definitely comes from you, because that's how our children adopt those musical skills. Also from their awesome teacher, Ms. Lawton, who's done such a great job at Fairgrade with her music classes. I love these kids so much, and it's been a lot of fun teaching them. I'm sure that you'll be pleased with the result. The kids love to play. You play all the time. I'm sure many of you have had students with multiple instruments coming home because I can't keep them in one instruments. It's been a lot of fun. So we're going to start off tonight with a nice, beautiful song entitled Song for Peace. Enjoy. We have pretty much almost a party happening in the band cave, as I like to call it, almost every day that I'm at Fairgrade. And they're always just playing new instruments and new songs. And they're like, can I play this song for the concert? I'm like, I have a hard time saying no. idea. So, therefore, we're going to head into a whole bunch of soloists before we head into the second last song. So our first friend to come up is going to be Matthew Goodley, and he's actually playing the theme from Swan Lake. Is going to be Maximus Martini. He's going to give us a little Pink Panther on his tenor saxophone. Recital sitting on the stage, besides the flies landing on his glasses because Hosmer Hall in Potsdam was full of flies, squeaked his way through the entire second movement of the song. They just happened. They happened to all of us. Nice job. So, our third performer is Michael Moll. He's going to give us a little Eye of the Tiger action. Until this year. These two young ladies actually talked about one once. So we were in our lesson, and they were working on this song that they wanted to play. And they said, Mrs. Kahn, let's go have a pop-up concert. I'm like, what's that? They're like, well, we'll go up to kindergarten and we'll play for them. I'm like, you can do that? Like, I never thought just to pop into someone's classroom and play a song for them. So we did that. Oh my, it was so cute. The kindergartners loved it. They were great listeners. So I thank these ladies for teaching me about the pop-up concert. So, please enjoy our flute players. We have Charlie Schaefer and Kaylee Halstead playing Bingo.
Thank you.
on to the next part. So, I have to tell you, I am kind of a lover of rock music. And I was really thinking about songs to work with the kids. And one of the things that we learn about music, you know, is music creates emotions. Like our first song, it was beautiful. It makes, oh, a beautiful song. But oftentimes, when people write music, there's different intentions. And for the next song, which is Smoke on the Water, it was written to actually tell the story of what happened to Deep Purple when they went to record at Frank Zappa's mobile recording studio, and how they were staying at the hotel across the lake from where Frank Zappa was performing. And the night of Frank Zappa and the Mothers of Invention's concert, somebody in the audience shot flare gun into the sky. And it literally caught the entire casino that they were performing at on fire. And it burned to the ground. And Deep Purple was in this hotel across, there's a lake separating the hotel from the casino. And literally they watched the casino burn to the ground. So if you Google search the words for Smoke on the Water, it's literally that exact story that I just told you. So when you smoke on the water, it's the smoke rolling across the water while they watch the casino burn to the ground. So, kind of a fun little story that goes with it. Plus, let's all admit, iconic riff. I mean, there's a list, right? You know, there's Iron Man and Godzilla and Smoke on the Water. I mean, everybody knows it. So enjoy Smoke on the Water. Because now that he's been playing around the piano, along with about five other instruments, When he comes over on the piano he's playing, he reminds me of the character Schroeder from Peanuts. So anyways, it's nothing I can throw at this boy except for flute. Flute is the only instrument that I've stumped him with. Have I stumped this child yet? So I decided one of the songs that I played when I was younger, and we thought we were really cool when we could play it, was the duet on the piano called Heart and Soul. So I taught it to Braden, and I'm going to tell you what, every single one of these band members can sing it, because Braden wasn't playing his own instrument, he was at the piano in the band cave playing the chords to Heart and Soul. So we are going to share the duet that we've worked so hard on with you, so we're going to walk down to the piano now so you can hear his accomplishment of Heart and Soul. So for the last song, this song, I was reflecting on this with them when we were waiting to come out, and I brought them back to the first band rehearsal that we had together, and I reminded them how hard this song was for them to play. One of the toughest things about playing in an ensemble is learning how to put three totally separate parts together and be able to play your own part without having the other part distract you. So we were talking about, wow, this song was so hard for us. We literally had to, take it bit by bit to put it together. And now they play through it like they were born knowing how to play. It's been amazing watching their progress. So this is 25 or 6 or 4. Once again, a story song, which is about the lead singer of Chicago trying to write the words to a song. Was in his hotel room and looked up at the clock while he's working. You know, gotta get this song done, gotta get this album out. And he looked up at the clock and he's like, oh, is it 25 or 26 minutes to 4? So that's why it's called 25 or 6 to 4. And if you're like me, I never knew that until I started teaching the song. I never knew what that title was. And I thought it was the weirdest name for a song, 25 or 6 to 4. What does that mean? Oh, and you know who taught that to me? My children. They're the ones that teach me all this trivia stuff. They're really kind of fun. So anyways, when you listen to the words to that song, once again, it talks about how he's trying to write the song. So definitely interesting to Google search those lyrics, or if you're on Spotify, have the lyrics pop up and you can see all that. So enjoy 25 or 6 to 4.
Thank you.
I have to tell you, in case you haven't noticed, Mrs. Stahl came tonight to play with us. First time. I was so excited to see her as a trumpet player herself. I love that she popped in to play along with us. Kids loved it. So thank you, Mrs. Stahl, for coming tonight. It was nice having you here. Thank you once again for all that you do to support your children. You do a great job. They're awesome kids. Thank you for sharing them with us, and thank you for coming out tonight. Have a wonderful evening, and thanks again.
Yes, let's give all our musical scholars and our pre-directors another round of applause. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen, for coming out tonight. We hope you enjoyed it. We've got another great one planned for June, and we'll see you here at the end of the school year. Thank you so much. Drive safely, everyone, and we'll see you next time.